Good morning, all of you. Today we will start the next unit, that is unit 6. It is satellite navigation and global positioning system. Okay, that is we are going to learn the application of satellite communication, a simple application of satellite communication, but every day we are using in our daily life. It is GPS. Yes, is global positioning system. The contents of this unit are radio and satellite navigations, GPS position location principles, GPS receivers and ports, satellite signal acquisition, GPS navigation message, GPS signal levels, GPS receiver code operation, GPS C/A code accuracy, differential GPS. These are the contents of the unit 6. First, we move into the introduction, that is radio and satellite navigation. So we all know, if we are going to a new place and we don't know the address properly, immediately we take the phone, mobile phone, we switch on the GPS. Okay, we switch on the GPS and we move into Google Maps and we'll try to find out the location or the distance. Okay, so do you know what is the technology which is running behind the GPS? Yes, it is satellite navigation, or it is due to satellites only. So global positioning system is used to locate the position of ships, aircrafts and targeting enemies warships. GPS uses L-band signals, and the position and accuracy of the GPS is 3 meters. That is, the accuracy is up to 3 meters, very high accuracy. So there are two types of position location systems. One is Navstar, another one is LoRaN. Navstar full form is Navigation System Timing and Ranging. LoRaN full form is Long Range Navigation. So compared to Navstar, LoRaN has less position accuracy. So generally Navstar is preferred for navigation or finding the location. So this Navstar is also called as global positioning system, that is GPS. Okay, so it is introduced in 1980s and till we are using this GPS. How GPS works? GPS consists of 24 satellites in MEO, medium earth orbit. That is, if you want to know the location, whenever you switch on the GPS in your mobile, your mobile, the GPS system in the mobile will be connected to satellites present in the medium earth orbit. Okay, so that too, a satellite constellation which consists of 24 satellites. A satellite constellation that consists of 24 satellites. Out of 24 satellites, your GPS system, present in your phone, will be connected to 3 satellites. Only 3 satellites are enough to find the position accurately. Okay, so how the GPS system is working? GPS consists of global positioning system consists of 24 satellites in medium earth orbit. Okay, the GPS receiver, that is nothing but GPS system, receiver system present in your phone, will connect to 3 satellites which are present in one constellation which consists of 24 satellites. Only 3 satellites in that constellation are enough to find the position accurately. The position of the GPS receiver is generally found by a method called as trilateration method. So what is this trilateration method? We'll know. In this method, the distance from unknown point from the 3 known points is measured. The distance of the unknown point from the 3 known points is measured. This method is called trilateration method. The 3 satellites transmit signals in L band, which are modulated by various codes. Among them, 2 codes are important. One is P code, another one is C/A code. P code is a high security code generally used for military applications, and C by A code is generally used by the public. Since 1980s, as I said, three satellites and the GPS receiver work with very high accurate clock called as atomic clocks. GPS receiver will not receive the signals from the three satellites at the same time. Okay, because all the three satellites in the constellation are not at the same position. They might be in different positions. So the GPS receiver will not receive the signals. The receiver present in your phone, for example, will not receive the signals from three satellites at the same time. Okay, one satellite will be sending first, another satellite will be sending next, and third satellite will be sending the signals after. Okay, so the transmitter signals, that is the signals transmitted by the satellites, will move with the velocity equal to the velocity of light. Okay, velocity equal to the velocity of light. Okay, so here you know the velocity of the signals, you know the time at which the signals are arrived at the receiver. Using this velocity and the time, you can calculate the distance from three satellites to the GPS receiver. Okay, from three satellites, where are those three satellites? You can get from the ephemeris data, that is data related pertaining to the three satellites. Okay, so the receiver calculates the distance of three satellites whose positions are specified in a rectangular coordinate system. For example, here is the GPS receiver. For example, see the picture. There are three satellites which are connected to the receiver. One satellite is transmitting the signal to the GPS receiver first, and the second one is transmitting the signals to the GPS receiver second, and later the third one. If you observe, these three satellites are not at the same position. They are at different positions. Okay, so the three satellites will be transmitting the signals to the GPS receiver. Okay, whose velocity, okay, is equal to the velocity of the light. So GPS knows at what time the first transmitter, the first satellite is send the signals, and at what time the second satellite send the signals, and at what time the third satellite send the signals. Okay, so it knows the time, and also it knows the velocity of the signals. So it will be able to calculate the distance between the first satellite and the receiver, second satellite and the receiver, third satellite and the receiver. When the three distances are known, obviously the unknown position can be found easily. This is called trial attrition method. This is called trial attrition method. Okay, this is how position of the GPS receiver, or position of the, it may be the vehicle, or it may be a war, enemy's warship. Okay, it may be the spacecraft, whatever it may be, its position can be determined accurately. Okay, up to 3 meters, accurately up to 3 meters. Okay, so that is the reason this global positioning system has very good significance in our day-to-day life as well as in military applications. So in the next class, we'll come with another topic, interesting topic. Okay, thank you.